Hi everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be doing another second order differential equations problem. And in this problem, they've asked us to solve the following initial value problem. Y double prime, or the second derivative of y, minus 18 times y prime, or the first derivative of y, plus 77y equals 0. And they've given us the following two initial conditions. Y of 0 equals 4, and y prime of 0 equals 8. So we're going to be using each of these pieces of information a little bit later on. But here's the formula that we're going to need. We'll get back to why we're using this specific formula in a second. So the first thing we want to do is convert our original equation here to an equation that involves r's instead of y's. And the reason we're going to do that is because our first step in this problem is solving for the variables here, r sub 1 and r sub 2 in our formula. The reason we use r is because they are the roots, the solutions to the equations. So we're looking for the solutions to our equation. So we're going to get r equal to two solutions, and we'll plug them in for r sub 1 and r sub 2, and then go from there. So the way that we convert our original equation into one that involves r's instead of y's is we just replace the variables y with r. But the way that we do it, the quickest, easiest trick that I found to do it is look at the number of hash marks that you have on the y's. It's not mathematical, but it's easy. You can see here we have y double prime. We have two hash marks, which means we're going to be looking at r to the 2, or r squared. So you see we put r squared here. 18y prime, we're looking at y with one hash mark, which means r to the 1. So we just have r here. And then here, y with zero hash marks, y to the 0 or r to the 0, anything raised to the 0 power is 1. So in place of y here, we're going to put a 1, not r, but because we have 0 hash marks, just a 1. So you can see here we have 77 without a variable attached to it. So that's, I think, the easiest way to replace y's with r's. And now we're going to factor this to solve for r. So this one's easy to factor. We end up with r minus 11 times r minus 7 equals 0. And when we solve this for r, we get two solutions, 11 and 7. So these are our two solutions for r, and we're going to go ahead and plug them in to our formula here for y of x. So when we do that, you can see we plug in 11 for r sub 1, and we plug in 7 for r sub 2. So we end up with the equation here, y of x. And the reason that we're using this formula, remember I said we would return to this, the reason that we're using it is because we ended up with two solutions for r, 11 and 7, which are distinct real roots of this equation, meaning these two solutions are real numbers and they are distinct from one another. They're not the same. So if we had ended up with two solutions, 7 and 7, like if our factoring was r minus 7 times r minus 7 equals 0, we would be dealing with two of the same real roots, and that would be a different formula. Sometimes you end up with complex conjugate roots, which would be yet a third formula. In this case, when we have distinct real roots, two real numbers that are different from one another, we use this formula here and plug them in for r sub 1 and r sub 2. So we have that, and now what we're going to do is find the derivative of y of x. And the reason that we're going to do that is because we're going to need both these formulas, y of x and y prime of x, so that we can use these initial conditions here, y of 0, which we'll associate here with y of x, and y prime of 0, which we'll associate with y prime of x. So we need to find these two equations so that we can use our initial conditions. So to take the derivative of y of x, remember that that when we have e to the x, the derivative of e to the x is just e to the x. But when we have a coefficient on that x exponent, when we take the derivative, we multiply that coefficient down in front. So we end up with 11 as part of the coefficient here. When we're taking the derivative, you can also ignore c sub 1 and c sub 2. They're just like coefficients, so they're always going to stay. They're always going to stay as part of both of these terms. Just deal with the part that involves the variable. So we bring 11 down in front, and similarly here, e to the 7x, the derivative is 7e to the 7x. We leave c sub 2, and this is what we get for our derivative, y prime of x. So once we've done that, we need to start using our initial conditions. So plugging in 0 to y of x here, we're looking at our first initial condition, y of 0 equals 4. We're going to be plugging in 0 for x and setting it equal to 4, and because this is the original y of x initial condition, we're using this equation here. So we plug in 0 for x and we set it equal to 4. And when we start simplifying, remember that anything raised to the 0 power is 1, so we're going to end up with e to the 0, so that will become 1. Same here, e to the 0 becomes 1, so when we simplify this further, we end up with the equation c sub 1 plus c sub 2 equals 4. So this is the result of plugging in our initial condition to the equation we generated here for y of x. We're going to hold on to this equation because we're going to need it later, but for now, what we'll do is use our second initial condition, y prime of 0 equals 8, we'll plug it into y prime of x here, and get the same or a very similar equation to the one that we just got here involving c sub 1 and c sub 2. So we'll need these two for reference, as well as the equation we generated from y of x. Let's go ahead and use our second initial condition, plugging in 0 for x to y prime of x, and setting it equal to 8. So you can see that we've plugged in 0, set it equal to 8, and again when we simplify, here we'll end up with e to the 0, which again will be 1 for both terms. So we'll end up with 11 c sub 1 plus 7 c sub 2 equals 8. And now, if we refer back to our equation from y of x, if we solve that for c sub 1 by subtracting c sub 2 from both sides, then we can plug in 4 minus c sub 2 for c sub 1 in this second equation. So it's kind of like using simultaneous equations to solve for the variables c sub 1 and c sub 2. So we'll plug in 4 minus c sub 2 for c sub 1, and when we multiply this out, we'll end up with 44 minus 11 c sub 2 plus 7 c sub 2 equals 8. We'll simplify, negative 11 c sub 2 plus 7 c sub 2 will give us a negative 4 c sub 2, and then subtracting 44 from both sides gives us a negative 36 on the right side. If we divide both sides by negative 4, we'll end up with c sub 2 equals 9. So the whole goal of this is to solve for c sub 2 and c sub 1 because those are the only two remaining variables from our formula. Here we ended up with y of x. We need to solve for c sub 1 and 2 to get our final answer. So now that we have c sub 2, we can plug it back into this equation here to find c sub 1. And we'll end up with c sub 1 equals 4 minus 9. And then, of course, when we simplify, we get c sub 1 equals negative 5. So now that we have those two, we'll plug back into our equation for y of x that we found. And you can see, let's look at the first one here. I plugged in negative 5 for c sub 1 and 9 for c sub 2. And you could leave this here as your final answer, but it's usually cleaner to not lead with a negative sign if you can avoid it. So I'm going to flip the terms and we'll have 9e to the 7x minus 5e to the 11x. And that's it. So that's our final answer. I hope it helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!